So Rastafari and the Tabernacle of David, right? I.e., righteous black king supremacy. And the righteous black king is the King of Kings upon the throne of David, the conquering lion of the tribe of Judah, Mo'an Besa, Ze'em Neged Yehuda, Haile Selassie I, Kedemawi, Haile Selassie, elect of God, Siyume Egeziabiher, King of Kings of Ethiopia, Negusa Neges, Ze Ethiopia. This is who we're speaking of. This is who is fulfilling and has fulfilled the tabernacle of David. Now, on the left-hand side of the screen, you have verse 16 and 17. That's from Acts of the Apostles, chapter 15. And we've been reasoning and meditating again on that particular chapter because it has to do with the Gentiles. And because of Satan's skin for skin game that he reveals in Job, right? That we're living in this, I call it post, white supremacist traumatic times, not just for black folks, but also for white folks. You know, because sometimes we speak about our black Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, we know that in spirit, we know that there's sometimes some discomfort and offense that some take. Some say it doesn't have to be about, you know, it's not about what color Jesus is. And it should be and should have been so-called that way, at least what color in the sense of racism. But if a lie has been told, right, and is still believed to be the truth, then we would be unrighteous if we did not confront that lie, right? But now to build our faith on that correcting of a lie, you know, would be a weak faith. So our faith is not just because Yeshua HaMashiach is black, because even in that time, they knew he was what we call today, so-called black. But there were still spiritual issues, as there are spiritual issues for Jah's people, both Jew and Gentile, or both black and white. So here in this portion of the scripture, right, we want to touch on the tabernacle of David, right? The tabernacle of David. What relationship does the tabernacle of David have with the tabernacle of Moses? Since we've been studying the tabernacle of Moses in the previous Torah portions that were concerning Shemot, the Hebrew book of Exodus, Orit Ze Tzaat in the Ethiopic, the Ge'ez, and in the HSV or Haile Selassie version of the Bible, the Metzaf Kedus, the Book of the Seven Seals, Revelation 5:5, speaking of Mo'an Besa, Ze'em Neged Yehuda, the conquering lion of the tribe of Judah. Now, we know there's many naysayers, you know, just as there were Pharisees and Sadducees and others, some of them who believed a little bit, but they still, some who did not believe that Yeshua, right, is he who be who he be, who many don't believe that his majesty is. But our role and responsibility is to recognize that the gospel, right, the Wengel, right, the good news of the King of Kings in Christ, right, that the gospel has never anywhere converted all, right? Let's just recognize, but everywhere has called out some. So the gospel or the good news in the past 2,000 years, right, since the crucifixion, the death, the burial, the resurrection, and the ascension of I Black Lord and Savior Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christus, the gospel has not everywhere, right, or anywhere actually converted all. So we have to recognize that, you know what I mean, and let that overstanding, it's about our testimony, right? It's about our bringing forward the good news of the King of Kings, the good news of his grace, of the grace of his son, our Savior, Yeshua HaMashiach, of the fulfillment of biblical scriptural prophecy, even to this very time, and especially in the person of Haile Selassie I, that righteous king, who is that tabernacle and represents that tabernacle of David, which was fallen down, and which it says right here, after this, I will return and will build again the tabernacle of David, which has fallen down, and will build again the ruins thereof, and I will set it up. Verse 17, that the residue, the residue is that remnant, right? It says, although Israel will be as the sand of the sea, right? And there are many who are, of Israel, right? Racially, might be black, and you could trace your roots, so forth and so on. But it's about the Israel of Ha-Elohim. It's about the Israel of Haile Selassie, the Israel that recognizes this fulfillment of prophecy from Amos 9:11. This is Amos 9:11 that James is quoting right here, that the residue of men might seek after Yahweh, after Jah's way, truth and life, and all the Gentiles. So the residue of men is the residue of Israel, right? And all of the Gentiles are the other non-Israelite nations, be they black or white, right? Upon whom my name, remember the new name in Revelation, my name is called. And I who has received the call of Rastafari, recognize the fulfillment of that new name, saith Yahweh, he who be who he be. So he has manifested himself to be Rastafari, right? Who doeth all these things. So we have a significant prophecy here, but I want to focus this on the tabernacle of David and to help to prompt the brothers and sisters, especially the Wendemotes, the brethren, and I co-laborers to study more on the tabernacle of David and this particular prophecy that we have from Amos chapter 9. Right? Now, what's so interesting is that this is Acts chapter 15. We have the Ethiopian eunuch in Acts chapter 8. Now, in Amos chapter 9, at verse 7, it reads, "Are ye not as the children of the Ethiopians unto me, O children of Israel?" So we see a clear Ethiopian Hebrew, or more correctly, according to the royal or the kingly order, right? The royal order of the Ethiopian Hebrews, that Ethiopia Israel, the true Ethiopian Hebrew connection right there in the scripture. So we have in the New Testament, the Ethiopian eunuch, Acts of the Apostles chapter 8. By the time we get to chapter 15, where we're at right here, there's a controversy concerning the Gentiles and their salvation. Some of the black Pharisees, right, said that, well, the Gentiles, whether they be Gentile black or Gentile white, they had to be circumcised according to the flesh, according to the manner of Moses. And it's interesting because in Leviticus chapter 12, it speaks about that when a woman, I think it's Bitarages, or it's the Torah portion that's coming up concerning begins off, and when I think, and she conceived, it's that Torah portion, but it's coming up, I think, either this upcoming Torah portion, or it's the one for Leviticus chapter 12, right? And there it speaks on the eighth day. So, see, this is how the religious are. You see, we're not being religious here. We're being spiritual in the spirit of the truth of his word. They were being religious and saying that it's almost like some people say, well, the Gentiles have to be black or do things in a so-called black way. But there's no righteousness, right, in the black apart from Yeshua HaMashiach, our black Lord and Savior. So let's recognize that. That does not exempt us, but the Gentiles are exempt from keeping the Torah or the law of Moses. Now, people say, well, how can this be? This is the same reasons why they thought that Paul was a false apostle, because Paul was able, through the Holy Spirit, to rightly divide these particular matters right here. So what we have right here, dispensationally, in Acts chapter 15 is very, very interesting. The quote that's being made, and that's made here at verses 16 and 17, are directly from Amos chapter 9. Amos chapter 9, verses 11 and 12. Now, there's a Schofield note I like to share with the eye of them on this. And this is getting a groundation and the foundation for that true church, which Rastafari has been called to fulfill in and through David and the keys of David, even David's greater son upon the throne of great King David, Katamawi Haile Selassie, the conquering line of the tribe of Judah. So this is one of the most important places dispensationally in the new covenant, because it gives the divine purpose of this age. Since we're coming to the end of this age, which is the times of the Gentiles, this is the divine purpose and is for the beginning, right, of the next, of the new, the true new age, right, or the true new world order in the King of Kings and his Christ. One, it's the taking out from among the Gentiles, the non-Ethiopian or black Hebrew nations, of a people for his name. And I see that as being fulfilled in Rastafari, right, in this dispensation, the distinctive work of the present or the church age, because this church age, we're in this church age, is coming to a fulfillment, right? And the true church, he says he will return and build his own church upon that Peter type of metaphor that he gives us. He says Peter, he uses Peter as an example. Now, the church is the ecclesia. The ecclesia is the outcalled assembly. Another important link right here in the Torah portion was Torah portion number 24, Vayikra, and he called. And that link between the beginning of the book of Leviticus, the Sefer HaKohanim, or the handbook of the priests, and Hebrews, which says that that another priest arise from a tribe that Moses spoke nothing of concerning priesthood, for it's evident that Adonai sprung out of the tribe of Judah. And the key word is conquering lion of the tribe of Judah, not the religion of Judaism. That's the key right there. Now, the church is the ecclesia, or the called out assembly, ek, out of, kalio, call. And that's what we get our word today in the English, call, ekkalio. Kalio means to call, ekkalio, ecclesia, called out ones. Now, precisely this has been in progress ever since Shavuot or Pentecost, as we have in Acts of the Apostles, Pentecost. Now, the gospel, once again, the good news has never anywhere converted all, but everywhere has called out some. So it's amongst those who are called out to the purpose of the King of Kings in Christ, whether Jew, black Hebrew, or Ethiopian Hebrew, or Gentile, right? The second item is this, quote, after this, vis-a-vis the outcalling, I will return. So after this, after what? After the call, vayikra, right? After the calling out, the called out once, erito, and he called, I will return. Now, James, right, or Jacob, Yaakov, the first bishop of the Church of Jerusalem, James, and we have his letter in the New Testament, the Epistle of James, right? Yaakov, his Hebrew name Jacob, he quotes from Amos chapter 9, verses 11 and 12. So he quotes Amos 9:11. Wow. How interesting, right? Sign and more sign. Ethiopian New Year, 9:11. Are ye not as the Ethiopian, the children of the Ethiopians unto me, O children of Israel? Now, the verses which follow in Amos describes the final regathering of Israel, the final regathering of spiritual Israel, which the other prophets, the Navim, the Nabiyat, invariably connect with the fulfillment of the Davidic covenant. All right, so for the fulfillment of the Davidic covenant, the key is David, is King David, right? And that key being fulfilled and revealed and manifest is in the person of Ketamawi Haile Selassie, which a large portion of those who call themselves Black Hebrews and Jews reject. This is very much in line with his word. That's why it says a remnant, right? A remnant. So here it says that the prophets all connected this with the fulfillment of the Davidic covenant, right? Of that king of righteousness, that black king, right? That Ethiopian king, even the king of kings of Ethiopia. So we have the fulfillment of the Davidic covenant, Isaiah chapter 11, verses 1, verses 10 to 12, Jeremiah chapter 23, verses 5 to 8 are very much key. And also speaking of the Passover, Seder, and the word, sound, and power right there. Now, thirdly, quote, and will build again the tabernacle of David, end quote. And will build again the what? The tabernacle, the tent of David, right? So the tent of David pertains to the worship, the Isis, right? It's the reestablishing of the Davidic, right, of David's rule over Israel, right? The reestablishing of David's rule over Israel. 2 Samuel chapter 7, verses 8 to 17. Luke chapter 1, verses 31 to 33. Fourthly, the fourth matter is, quote, that the residue of men, speaking of Israelites, right? And we are speaking according to seed, you know, Black Hebrews, or those, especially in the West, in this Western dispensation, this North country, right? That the residue of men, Israelites, may seek after Yahweh, may seek after Yehovah, right? Zechariah chapter 12, verses 7 and 8. Zechariah chapter 13, verses 1 to 2. And the fifth matter is this, and all the Gentiles, right? All the other nations, the Ahzab, Micah chapter 4, verses 2, Zechariah chapter 8, verses 21 and 22. This is also the order that we have in Romans chapter 11, verses 24 to 27, right? So there's the order has already been laid out. He's waiting for that generation that seeks the face of the God of Yaakov, right? The face of the God of Jacob. Now, the scope of the decision that was made by this first, we can say, church council, so to speak, right? This first church council, or the council at Jerusalem in Acts of the Apostles chapter